So you quite like my hair?
I do. I like your colour.
It's like a poor imitation of Pete Davidson. How are you doing, Mum? How are you doing?
That's good.
I've never seen a more V-shaped V-neck. Look at the size of that V.
I know.
How V is that? You've got a series of T-shirts with the same V-neck.
I know, Mum. And do you know what? I never wear them normally, and then suddenly they've all come out together for this.
Why has this particular trip been V-neck trip?
I don't know. It's because they're all together in my room.
I've just seen some tzatziki crisps passing in the background, and there is something.
Yeah, I can tell you why I suddenly went like this.
Nothing nicer than tzatziki.
There is.
Okay, all right, well, Guillermo del Toro. He's got a lovely face.
Guillermo del Toro.
Don't you love his face?
I do, but then he did that film which isn't very good.
Which one? Come on, put your nail your colours to a mark.
Water's something to do with water, the shape of.
The shape of water. Maddie hated it. I didn't like it. I liked Michael Shannon.
Yeah, I like Michael Shannon, but I didn't really like anything else about it.
Right, well, a lot of people did. They saw it as a perfect modern-day fairy tale.
Sure.
Yeah,
didn't it win the Oscar
for Best Picture?
I tell you what his best film is.
Pan's Labyrinth?
The Devil's Backbone.
The Devil's Backbone is brilliant. And Kronos. Okay. He made Kronos back in 1993. I remember Kronos. I had it on DVD. I mean, 1993 was when I'd just come out of university, yeah.
I thought you were saying I'd just come out. I was going to say
Kronos was radical and revolutionary. The Devil's Backbone has a huge
it's
cult
fabulous.
Following.
Fabulous.
And then, obviously,
it
he did.
Deserves it.
Yeah, and obviously, he did the Hellboy films.
Did he?
Yeah. But Pan's Labyrinth seemed to be the film that kind of got everyone excited. And I like it, but I don't love it.
No, exactly.
And I feel bad for saying that.
I think that it is the film that makes people turn to him, so that's probably why it's so popular.
Yeah, yeah. So are you he's sort of magic realist. Tell us what your thoughts on magic realism are.
Well, I love magic realism on stage at South American and all of that, but I'm not so mad keen on it now.
What, do you think it was very much of its time?
I do a bit, actually.
Of its magical time?
Yeah, and I mean, I know more about books and films, but some books try to do it still.
Right.
And it doesn't work unless it's with a really, really, really modern take.
Right, okay.
Which I think maybe is what he was trying to do in The Shape of Water.
I think he was. I do think he endeavours to be a modern day sort of Grimm's fairy tale.
And Gabriel Marquez.
Yeah, and Gabriel García Marquez. So he's Mexican. He's incredibly inventive. I mean, the thing about him is he's inspired and aspirational, and he's always trying to push the boundaries. And I think you've got to give credit where credit's due.
And look at that face.
No, a lovely face. He also directed more recently Nightmare Alley, which we reviewed on this channel. Kind of all right.
Just all right.
It wasn't as good. I mean, a lot of people loved it, but again, just all right.
Also, there should be no way you could fail with that because it's about carnies and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. And carnivals. Anyway, well, he's got a new film coming out, and it's a stop frame animation film.
Oh.
And the stop frame animation film is. Try and guess what it is.
I don't know.
It's.
Ants.
Pinocchio.
No way.
He's doing Guillermo del Toro's Pinocchio.
That's why he's doing it because the name.
Because it's called Guillermo del Toro.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he's put that there because he's.
Oh, no, sorry. Collodi, it is who wrote the book, isn't it? Yeah. I've got the names mixed up. Sorry.
The voiceover artists in this, one of them is curious.
Legion.
Well, one of them is really curious because it is Ewan McGregor playing Jiminy Cricket, Sebastian J. Cricket, Gregory Mann, I don't know, as Pinocchio, David Bradley as Master Geppetto, Christoph Waltz as Count Volk,
he's always good.
Tilda Swinton as the fairy with turquoise hair, Finn Wolfhard as Candlewick, and Ron Perlman as the Podesta.
Now he's the Cate guy Blanchett that he uses for Hellboy, isn't he? Ron
yeah, Perlman. That's right, yeah. And Cate Blanchett is in there. John Turturro's in there. So it's a heck of a voiceover cast.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering whether this could be his sort of, Fantastic Mr. Fox moment. You know, for Wes Anderson.
Yeah, no.
So anyway, so this has just released a teaser. My feeling about Pinocchio is it's been overdone too many times by different people badly.
Do you think?
Yeah, and I'm not entirely convinced by the fairy tale. Well, no, but there's been lots of sort of substandard animated versions.
Oh, have there?
And there's also a live-action version with Tom Hanks coming out, isn't there?
I don't
know. Disney Plus. Anyway, well, I'm hoping that this kind of revitalises it. I want a Pinocchio to be dark, twisted, and really,
so do
really
I, Mark.
Creepy.
So do I.
I mean, I find him creepy anyway, don't you?
Yes, certainly.
Do you?
Yeah.
All right, well, let's check it out.
Mark.
Well, it doesn't do that. It kind of goes like that.
Who's Ewan McGregor again?
It's, Jiminy Cricket.
So he's Scottish.
Scottish Jiminy Cricket.
Let's go. It looks nice.
From my many wanderings on this earth, I had so much to say about imperfect fathers and imperfect sons, and about loss and love. I've learned that there are old spirits who rarely involve themselves in the human world, but on occasion, they do. I want to tell you a story. It's a story you may think you know, but you don't. A story. Of the wooden boy.
Where am I?
I feel as though you've been here before. The wooden boy with the borrowed soul. Be his son. Fill his days with light. We shall call you Pinocchio.
Oh, what a day, what a day.
Wow.
A wooden boy with a borrowed soul.
Whoa, is that what it said just then?
No, that's what they said in the trailer.
Oh, did they?
Yeah. Are you paying attention?
I am paying
what
attention.
What did we just watch?
I like that a lot.
The wooden boy with a borrowed soul. Sounds like me.
No, because you're not wooden and you haven't got a borrowed soul.
I don't borrow
my
soul.
Other than that, I like the look of it.
Did you?
Well, I like the woodiness of the...
The wood looked woody.
It did look woody, didn't
and also,
it?
And also, I'll tell you what it reminded me that I'd forgotten, is that he comes from a tree.
Well, they told us that in the first 2 seconds, didn't they? And I think therein lies all the mistakes that happen afterwards, don't you?
Why? What?
Well, because it's a tree and he's cut it down.
Oh, do you think
it's... The tree might be angry.
So do you think the whole Pinocchio sort of fairy tale, it evolves from the fact that a tree is angry that it was chopped down?
It could be, from all that we now know about trees, which we didn't know then.
Do you know what?
What?
That... If the girls were younger, they would have loved that. I would have taken them to see that. There was a real sort of warmth to it.
There was.
I was surprised that Ewan McGregor's voice worked as Jiminy Cricket.
Yeah.
The stop frame animation is very nicely done. It's very tenderly done. And there's a real sense of wood.
There is. I don't know if maybe the music was a bit overdone.
Too much, a bit saccharine.
Yeah. Guiding us towards this.
A bit like eight Canderel in one of your espressos.
Yes, exactly. Good.
Good analogy.
Good analogy.
Yeah. I like the look of that. I'm quite looking forward to it. If I was a parent with kids, I'd be thinking, oh yeah, and it might deliver a little bit of that sinisterness.
Yeah, I think it will.